Hello and welcome to an update about Quant. Yeah, Quant seems to be suggesting the chart, suggests that the low has been in here. As I already said in the previous video, $40, $41. That was the ideal area down there to accumulate, sort of in that range, yeah, between the 88.7 and the 78.6% FIB level. I've taken that area now off the chart, but that was always the reversal area for such a larger correction. And yeah, there was time to accumulate, and now we are moving out of it. And we have clearly left that area. We are now moving up impulsively here. My view is that we have completed, you might not see that behind the FIBs there, but that we have completed here a 1, a 2. This year was the 3 and the 4. Within the 3, an extended wave 3, we had also 5 waves. We are now coming down in a 4. Maybe the wave 4 is already complete. We can take a look at that from a retracement point of view. You can see that we perfectly reached the 23.6% FIB level at $96. That is a retracement level for a wave 4 that is absolutely okay. It is the minimum it should do, but it is when there is a very bullish environment, which, to be honest, Quant seems to be in, then the cryptos in a wave 4 often only see that 23.6% FIB level. So be on high alert that wave 4 could already be in here. However, a low below that $94 level, that's how low we came, yeah. I'll zoom in a little bit. That's how low we came. Oops, didn't want to move that. So a move below this swing low would suggest, here below $94, would suggest that wave 4 hasn't finished yet. If wave 4 hasn't finished yet, then we could expect the next support to be reached, which is the 38.2% FIB level at 85.50. That is normally the ideal level for a wave 4. So until we really get above the previous high at $114, $115, we can't really see wave 4 is complete. So we need to still be careful. Yeah, wave 4 could definitely come down once more lower. Breakout point here above $114, $115 would take us higher, possibly into the region around $115 to $120. I think I mentioned it in the previous video, maybe even $125. But the problem is that a wave 5, only really strictly to fulfill its duties, yeah, or requirements, it just needs to be an impulsive move up slightly above the previous wave 3. So it doesn't really need to go much above $113, to be honest, okay? Or $114, that was here. $115, yeah. So there's various ways how this can be counted. So it's just really to fall back to these critical breakout levels. And that anybody who tries to trade this long, just be aware. Yeah, I'm not telling you to do it or not. Just be aware that this last move up here could be short. Then this is the wave 5. This is the last leg up of an impulse. So I would rather after that expect another pullback. As you can see here in a green wave 2. All of this was a higher level wave 1. We are going to see a pullback in a wave 2. As soon as we know how high wave 1 will go, when we see clear reversal signal, then I will reformulate here the whole target for that wave 2 in green. I can already give you an indication, assuming we might reach $130 here in that wave 1, then we would expect to move down into the region between $85 and $75. Yeah, that would then be a level that we come back into. That would be another 30% drop roughly from where we are now, depending on where we eventually will reach it. Yeah, not quite 30 maybe, but this would be another entry point for anybody who thinks he or she missed the boat here on the way up. Yeah, this is definitely, and it could go even lower. Yeah, I mean, a wave 2 can move down lower. What I would do, yeah, let's say we formulate a target here then for that wave 2, yeah, maybe even down to the 78.6% FIB level. I would buy in stages, just above the 50% FIB level, just above the 61.8, and just above the 78.6. If, for example, the last order doesn't get filled, then I'll keep that for the next entry point. But I think that is the best way how to play the market in this environment. dollar cost averaging in, but based on Elliott wave targets. Okay, and it could be that the last wave doesn't get filled, or the last buy order, that's fine, but then keep it for the next one. Yeah, and then this is how, where I would definitely get into Quant and add to my positions. Okay, and that's currently where we are. So here, bottom line is, we are at the end of an uptrend. There will be another leg up, in my opinion, but it won't be massive. Yeah, probably. Yeah, it can be traded, but the risk is just it can be a bit short. And there was a larger pullback expected after that. It's still a corrective pullback. So after that, we should see a wave three to the upside. Anybody who wants to buy now just holds through, and there should be another wave up afterwards. But of course, you know, it would be more clarity, and we will be on the safer side if we wait for that ABC down, and if we see if it really makes a higher low, because nothing is guaranteed in these markets. It's just what we need to see to get this bullish breakout carried out, that we then in this wave two have an ABC pattern down, a three wave move. And if that really makes a higher low, and we see a first small impulse emerging out of the green box, that is a really good indication that this is going higher. Okay, so that's my view about Quant. Hopefully you liked the update. If you did, please hit the like button, leave a comment and subscribe. And if you really like the content, please check out the channel membership. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye bye.